Question 3 of this exercise asks us to find the roots of the following equations. So there are two parts in this question, and both the equations are not in the standard quadratic form. So we have to solve them and we have to find the values of x which satisfy these equations. So let's start with the first part. So in the first part, the equation is x minus 1 by x equal to 3. And we are also told that x is not equal to 0, because if x is equal to 0, then this term 1 by x will be undefined. So let's modify this equation and write it in standard quadratic form. So if we take, so we have x and we have 1 minus x here. So if we take the LCM for the two terms on the left hand side, we get x in the denominator, we get x square from this first term x, and we get minus 1 from this numerator. So we have x square minus 1 by x is equal to 3. And now if I cross multiply x to the right side, I will get x square minus 1 equal to 3x, or x square minus 3x minus 1 equal to 0. So now this equation is in the standard quadratic form with the coefficients as a equal to 1, b equal to minus 3, and c equal to minus 1. So a is the coefficient of x square, b is the coefficient of x, and c is the constant term. Now what we can do is we can apply the quadratic formula and find the roots of this equation. So the roots will be x equal to minus b plus minus root of the discriminant b square minus 4ac by 2a. So let's plug in the values for a, b, and c. So we'll get minus b, which is plus 3, because b is minus 3, so minus b is plus 3, plus minus root of, so we have now b square, which is 9, minus 4ac, so 4 times a is 1, times c is minus 1, and then in the denominator we'll have 2 times a, or 2 times 1. So this is what we get. So now let's evaluate what these roots are. So we have 3 plus minus root of, we have 9 minus 4 times minus 1, so that's plus 4. So 9 plus 4 is 13, so 3 plus minus root 13 by 2. So these are the two roots of this equation. So one root is corresponds to the plus sign, so that's 3 plus root 13 by 2. So that's one root, x equal to 3 plus root 13 by 2, and the other root corresponds to the minus sign, so that will be 3 minus root 13 by 2. So these are the two roots of the equation in part 1. Now let's find the values of x which satisfy the equation in part 2. So in part 2, the equation is 1 by x plus 4 minus 1 by x minus 7 equal to 11 by 30, and we're told that x is not equal to minus 4 or 7, because if x equal to minus 4, then this first term will become 0, undefined, because the denominator becomes 0, and if x is equal to 7, then the second term will become undefined, because the denominator x minus 7 will become 0. So x cannot take these values. And now we have to find the values of x which satisfy this equation. So once again, this is not written in the standard quadratic form. So let's first convert it and rewrite this as an equation in quadratic form. So we have two terms on the left hand side. So let's take the LCM of the denominators. So we will get x plus 4 times x minus 7. And then corresponding to the first numerator 1, we will get x minus 7, and then minus corresponding to the second numerator 1, we will get x plus 4. So this is how we can combine the two terms on the left hand side, and this is equal to 11 by 30 on the right hand side. So now let's simplify and see what we get. So in the numerator, we'll get x minus 7 minus x plus 4. So the x terms cancel out, and we're left with minus 7 minus 4. So that's minus 11 by x plus 4 times x minus 7 equal to 11 by 30. So we can divide both sides by 11. So we'll get minus 1 here and we'll get 1 here. And now we can cross multiply. So on the left hand side, we can multiply minus 1 with 30. So we'll get minus 30. And on the right hand side, we can multiply 1 with this product of binomials. So we'll get x plus 4 times x minus 7. Now let's expand this product of binomials on the right hand side, so that this will be x times x, so that's x square. Then x times minus 7, minus 7x, and 4 times x is 4x, so minus 7x plus 4x is minus 3x, and then we have plus 4 times minus 7 is minus 28. So this is equal to minus 30. And now let's shift this minus 30 to the right side. So minus 30 becomes plus 30, and plus 30 minus 28 is plus 2. So this equation can be finally written as x square minus 3x plus 2 equal to 0. So let me rewrite it again here. So we modified this whole equation into this quadratic equation x square minus 3x plus 2 equal to 0. Now we can solve it by applying the quadratic formula, or we can solve it by completing the square, or in this case we can also easily factorize this quadratic expression by splitting minus 3x as minus 2x minus x, and then plus 2 equal to 0. So from the first pair of terms we get x times x minus 2, and from the second pair of terms we get minus 1 times x minus 2. So this is equal to 0, and this means that x minus 1 times x minus 2 is equal to 0. So this is how we can factorize this quadratic expression. So from here we can easily conclude that the roots are x equal to 1 and x equal to 2. So the two roots of this equation in the second part are x equal to 1 and x equal to 2, and that solves part 2 of this question.
To learn more about how QMath can help you crack school and board exams, explore QMath Leap, a live online classroom program run by highly experienced and committed teachers.